Welcome to the tutorial on the GeoResGlobe integration with GSQ Open Data Portal. In this tutorial, we'll learn how to access the GSQ Open Data Portal index layers and topic. Search the portal using related features in the permit or geoscience layers. Filter the results table. Send a search to the portal using selected records from the results table. And use a custom shape to find portal data that is available over a specified area. GSQ Open Data Portal Layer Group. The layers in the GSQ Open Data Portal group show the location and spatial extent of reports, datasets, and maps stored in the GSQ Open Data Portal. To view the Open Data Portal layers, open the Layers panel and select Add Layers. Select the drop-down arrow next to GSQ Open Data to view the available options. Then check the box next to the layers you would like to search the portal for. Alternatively, you can add these layers through topics. Open the Topics panel and search for GSQ to find the GSQ Open Data Portal topic. And select Launch Topic to add the layers to your map. In this example, we will turn on the report index. If the report index does not appear straight away, you may need to zoom in further on your map. The data is very detailed, so the layer is set to turn on after you have zoomed in past a predefined scale. To find reports in a particular area, zoom to the approximate location you are interested in and use the Identify tool. For this example, we will use the Rectangle tool to select an area and view the results in the results table. You can refine your results by selecting the Filter button, which enables you to choose particular fields and attributes associated with the data. For example, if you are only interested in petroleum reports, select the Commodity field and the Contains operator. Then type in petroleum and select Add. This narrows your results to only reports associated with petroleum within the selected area. To view these results in the portal, use the checkbox to select all the items, then select the GSQ Open Data Portal button, which opens a portal in a new browser window. Here you can see all the items related to the search you defined in GeoResGlobe. To find reports associated with a chosen permit, first turn on some permit layers, such as the exploration permits. Then identify the permits in your preferred area. Select the arrow next to the permit you are interested in. This shows a link to the GSQ Open Data Portal for that particular record. If no report is available for this permit, the link will be grayed out. Clicking on a blue link will open the portal in a new window and return reports related to the permit. If you prefer to view all permits within the area, use the checkbox to select all items in the results table and use the GSQ Open Data Portal button to open the portal in a new browser window. This returns the reports associated with all of the permits selected in the results table. Another useful way to find portal data within a defined area is to use custom shapes. This is useful if you don't know which layers contain the data you are interested in. Use the drawing tools to create a shape over an area of your map. This shape will now appear in places. Open the attributes to reveal the intersect GSQ Open Data Portal item. This uses the geometry of your created polygon to run an intersect against all of the layers within the GeoResGlobe that have linkages to the portal. Add a buffer to refine the data returned for the area. A buffer of -1 meter will return data only within that polygon, whereas a buffer of +100 meters will return abutting features as well. For this example, we will only include data within the polygon, so we'll apply a buffer of -1 meter. The results table will now contain items from all layers within GeoResGlobe that are linked to data within the portal. Now you can select an item you are interested in, open it within the portal, and download the relevant reports. Or use the checkbox to select all of the results to view within the portal. This concludes the tutorial. If you would like more detailed information, please check the FAQs and other tutorials in this series.